Hi there, this is Doug. Several people have asked me to highlight some of the audio equipment that I use. Most people know that I'm a bit of an audiophile, and I've got friends that are as well. My friend Chris is a big audiophile as well. And anyways, I thought I'd make a small little video that will highlight some of the equipment that I've got in my home theater system. So for those of you that are interested in audio and video, I hope you'll enjoy this little tour. So let's start off here. You can see that I've got all my equipment mounted up in a large wooden cabinet. And on either side of the television, there are racks for equipment. So typically it's audio, video, gear. The main pieces are on the left and right hand side. So let's go take a look, and I'll start off with the control unit for my audio visual system. This is a Denon AVR 2803. It's a few years old, but it means that it's got a lot of analog inputs on it, as well as some, you know, traditional stereo and composite video. So it's pretty versatile. I've had this unit for well over 10 years, and it's 7.1 surround sound with a number of surround sound modes, and also a number of stereo and simulated concert hall things. So it's an excellent receiver. Pumps out about, I think it's somewhere around 50 to 70 watts per channel. On top of it, you can see that I've got a Harman Kardon equalizer, and this is for my my analog input coming in from devices like my CD player or my turntable or cassettes or my open reel. So with this unit, I can tweak the bass and treble on each channel, and I have it set generally for matching my main speakers. Speaking of main speakers, these are my stereo speakers that come in from my stereo amplifier. There's a separate amplifier for my stereo speakers, and these speakers are called Swans, S-W-A-N-S. They're Chinese-made speakers, and they're virtual copies of B&W speakers. So they're very high efficiency, beautifully made. You can see that they're solid rosewood cabinets, and they've got piano lacquer finish. And they're superb sounding and very efficient. So beside the main speaker, I have a shelf consisting of lots of basically DVDs and Blu-rays. On top of the unit, you can see that I've got a number of small speakers. These are Klipsch surround sound speakers. I have seven of them. Six surround, and here's a Klipsch center channel speaker. So for my movies, this is what I use for getting my surround sound. This would be my other Swan speaker, separately powered stereo speaker. For bass, I have a couple of powered Klipsch subwoofers, so that if I'm watching something, you know, in surround sound, I can shake the house down. Or if I've got some good rock and roll that I want to blast up the bass on, I can shake the house. Enjoy that very much. This shelf has got basically Xbox on it. I don't use it all that much. My son Jeffrey does. And I've got a little analog switch on here for changing the preamp inputs for phono. This is my turntable. The turntable is a Mitchell Brothers, and it's called a Techno Deck. And on it, I have a Ortofon red cartridge. You'll have to excuse the bird making noise in the background. Below that, I have a realistic 8-track player recorder that I recently rebuilt, and it's fun to play 8-tracks. I'm recording also some of my own. And at the bottom of this particular rack, I have a Monster Power filter and power distribution unit that supplies the power, filtered and clean power to this rack of equipment. I mentioned that I have separate stereo speakers, the Swans. They're powered by mono amplifiers. These are mono blocks. These are made by a company called Shanling SP80s. They're about 80 watts of power each. This is the left channel amplifier, and this is the right channel amplifier. You can see that they're large, heavy, and they have tubes. So they're tube amplified for extremely warm sound. My preamp here is from a company called Mingda. It's a Japanese company. You can see all the tubes on it. It will take the input from CD players and also open reel players, cassette decks, also the 8-track, and so on and so forth. And there's a setting to play the turntable, and I can set the impedance for magnetic cartridge, either a moving magnet or a moving coil cartridge. The Ortofon is a moving coil cartridge. Here I have my CD player. It plays CDs and SACDs. It's also Shanling. And the amplification, pre-amplification is done by tube. So it's a combination of digital and old school analog. I have a small little stereo amplifier here for my headphones. The other mono block. Going into the other cabinet, the rightmost cabinet, I have a TIAC open reel tape deck. It's three motor and bi-directional. It's a 7-inch reels on it, not the 10-inch, but it fits nicely into the cabinet. And I record, for the most part, directly from vinyl LPs onto the tape recorder. I'm not playing it through the amp at this point in time. I don't have it switched in, but you can see that basically it's a fairly standard open reel. I really love open reels. I've had them for most of my life. Below that, I have a Monster Power amplifier, a conditioning unit, actually, a power conditioning unit for this rack of equipment. So everything in this rack is powered off of this Monster Power conditioner. Here's something, a blast from the past. I've got a VHS tape deck. It's a Super VHS deck, plays regular and Super VHS tapes. Below that, I have a Pioneer Laserdisc player with the traditional 12-inch laser discs. I've got a significant collection of those, and I play them on occasion. The picture quality was state-of-the-art back then. Now it's pretty fuzzy, but it's nice to have it, and once in a while I treat myself to looking at some of the old laser discs. Below that, I have a auto-reverse cassette deck, an Akai. GXC65D, which is the same unit I had in college. And the unique thing about it is that it will actually play the cassettes and auto-reverse them by flipping them around. I need to put one in to show you. So let me just grab a cassette here. I'll put it in. Press play. And you can see that it is playing. And the cool thing about it is it's auto-reverse, so when it gets to the end, it will flip. And there's also a manual control here to switch it. It brings the cassette in, flips around 180 degrees, and pops it back down. Below that, I have a second cassette deck. This one is a Pioneer from basically the mid to late 1970s. And I've reconditioned this one and it works fine. And below that I have a Philips DVD recorder. So if I want to make my own DVDs, I can do that. I don't do it that often, but I do have the ability to do it if I want. So obviously I have the television here and surround sound speakers in the back and surround sound speakers up in the front. So let me make a very, very small little recording. I'll turn on the turntable and I'll bring it over to the beginning. This is a Jethro Tull record, I believe. Let's see here. I'll go to the preamp. Turn the volume up. You can't hear the quality of the recording because I'm doing it off a telephone, off an iPhone. But it's superb. It's very, very crystal clear and crisp. For the video side, I have an Android TV box here, and I run software on it called Kodi. And you can see that I get lots and lots of channels, including a bunch of stuff from UK and from Canada. So I can watch Canadian TV. Go take a look at the CD player. Let's play a CD. I have one in here. I don't know what's in it. I'm just going to turn it on and play whatever's on track one. So I need to change the input to CD. Roxy Music Avalon. See, it's a top-loading CD player. And the preamp stage on it is tube. Now, to control all this, I have a few remotes. Here's a remote collection for the audio visual system. Well, I hope you enjoyed the little tour. Take care, talk to you soon.